Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we are going to cover the graphic user interface of the pattern recognition application of neural network toolbox in MATLAB. So the pattern recognition application can be opened in three ways. Type NN start and click on pattern recognition application, or go to the apps tab and click on neural net pattern recognition, or you can directly type in NPR tool. Now you can read the introduction. So what it basically says that in pattern recognition, you want the neural network to classify inputs into a set of target categories. So as you can see in the graphic here, we have input, then we have one hidden layer with the sigmoid transfer function. And then in the output layer, we have the softmax transfer function. As you might remember, in case of time series neural network and in case of data fitting neural network, we have linear activation output function. But in case of classification problem, we need to saturate the output within a particular range so that we can classify the data. As you may recall, you can also use tan hyperbolic function or tan sigmoid function for saturation. But the main advantage of using softmax is that the output probability range. The range will be 0 to 1 and the sum of all the probabilities will be equal to 1, whereas it will not be the case for sigmoid activation function. If the softmax function used for multi-classification model, then it returns the probability of each class and the target class will have the highest probability. Sigmoid function can also be used for classification, but only in case of binary classification. Whereas for multi-classification tasks, we will be using softmax activation function. So click on next. In this window, you need to select the input and target matrices. So click on load example dataset and select type of class. In this, we have different parameters of different glass samples, and for the target classification, we are classifying whether a glass with the above mentioned parameters will be a window glass or a non-window glass. So click on import. As you can see, these are the glass inputs, the 9 parameters for the different 214 glass samples we have. And for the target matrix, 0 means false and 1 means true. So what it means that for the first glass input with different parameters, it will not be a window glass and it will be a non-window glass. Similarly for second glass sample and so on for the 214 samples we have. Click on next. In this window, we can divide the dataset we have in the training, validation and testing dataset. I will keep the values at default and click on next. In this, you can define the number of hidden layer neurons for the single hidden layer we have. So I will keep it at 10 and click on next. Now the network is created. As you can see, here we will be using the scale conjugate gradient backpropagation and not the Leeuwenberg-Marquardt algorithm or similar algorithm. Because these algorithms are designed for least square problems that are approximately linear. Because the output neurons in pattern recognition problems are generally saturated, so you will not be operating in the linear region. So for the pattern recognition, the fastest algorithm is resilient backpropagation. But we can also use this scaled conjugate gradient backpropagation as it is nearly as fast as that of resilient backpropagation. The main advantage of using train SCG is that it can also be used in data fitting or time series network as well as for classifying programs. So click on train. After the network is trained, the window will look like this. So we have 9 inputs and 2 outputs. The data is divided randomly and we are using train SCG training algorithm. Now we are using the performance function as cross entropy, which involves the logarithmic terms. We could also use the mean square error, but in case of mean square error, the weight adjustment for the values close to a target, that is the target will be either 0 or 1, is very less, so thus the training can slow down. But in case of cross entropy, that is involving the logarithmic terms, such case will not occur because after derivative of the cross entropy function, the term which is responsible for slowing down in case of mean square error, that term will be eliminated for this cross entropy performance function. Epochs represent the number of epochs, time is the total number of time, performance is the cross entropy, gradient is the slope, and validation check. Now let's discuss the different plots we have available. Performance plot gives the performance, that is cross entropy versus the number of epochs. Training state gives the number of graphs like gradient and validation failed with respect to number of epochs. Error histogram gives the number of times a particular amount of error has occurred. So instances will be on y-axis and error, that is target minus output, will be on x-axis. Now these two plots, that is confusion and receiver operating characteristic, gives how accurate our classification is. So click on confusion. It will open up the confusion plot. On the confusion matrix plot, the rows correspond to the output class and the columns correspond to the target class. And the diagonal cells correspond to the observations that are correctly classified. So out of total of 37 output belonging to the class 1, 30 are classified accurately, that is they are belonging to class 1, but 7 are classified wrongly, so they are written in the red block and the correct are written in the green block, and the 7th are classified as class 2. Similarly, for 113 outputs in the training division for the target class, we have 112 correctly classified and only one is incorrectly classified. This in the gray block represents the percentage for the output class. So this can be obtained by 30 divided by 30 plus 1, that is 96.8 will be, and similarly 1 divided by 31. And in the blue block represents the overall classification performance. Do note that this is for the training division. Similarly, we can make it for validation as well as test division. Click on receiver operating characteristics. This will open up the ROC plot for different division, that is training, validation and test. ROC is the graph between the true positive rate and the false positive rate, or you can say between sensitivity and 1 minus specificity. So it tells the accuracy of our classification for each of the training, validation and test data. So how to read it? So greater will be the area under this curve, greater will be the accuracy of our classification, that is the better will be the network trait. So the area will be varying from this gray line to the output lines that we have. So the area under this gray line will be 0.5, and the maximum area you can get from this ROC plot is 1. So the area will be varying from 0.5 to 1. For high accuracy of the classification, this plot should remain on the left side of the graph. Click on next. In this window, you can train again the network by adjusting the network size or importing a larger dataset. Click on next. In this window, you can generate the MATLAB function or generate a Simulink diagram along with the network diagram. So click on next. Click on SQL script. This script will be discussed in the next video, and click on save results. This will save the result in the MATLAB workspace. So that's it everyone, this is it for this video. If you like it, please like, subscribe and share, and thanks for watching.